Once upon a time, in a faraway land, where dreams and reality are one and the same, a student by the name of Billy had begun preparations for his biochemistry exam.
Boy, I organized all them parties, but that Pentose Phosphate party was real hard, like in real trouble. But hopefully he might be an optional question, we could choose one, what do you think?
Boy, we already have time to study that, you know. I feel I gotta take down next week, boy. See what I take down next week? It's real wood. But right now, boy, I started taking down Zen, boy. Let me make a look on mine a little bit to be Zen now, boy.
Zen, you say, boy?
Zen, boy.
Nah, boy, I can't make that, boy. I'll get real wood. I telling you. But here, what will I gonna be home mining too, so. But I gonna wipe my pen, this must be part three.
I hear you.
Alright, but hopefully I might get it, I might understand it, hopefully.
Yeah.
First of all, I just want to say before I leave, I just want you all to know, you know, best of luck in exams and make sure I'm prepared all aspects of the course outline, especially the pathways, because a lot of work have been done throughout the semester. And there are a lot of podcasts online that will assist you in every way possible. And you know, best of luck in exams.
Yeah.
Wee boy, this exam real easy, boy. Jason Matthews could not bring this exam any easier. I sure after this I'll get 100% for sure. Wait, Matthew, watching in my paper, boy. This paper really easy, I loving it. What wrong with Marcus? Are you only watching in my paper, boy? Wee boy. This man really bring this question, boy. I never thought he would have bring this. Why going and write for this, boy? God, boy. Thing hot in me.
Boy. Why are we here, though? He's looking real strange.
Billy. I've been watching you for some time now.
Who is that?
Design. Your fairy godfather.
My fairy godfather?
Yes, I've been watching you struggling with this pentose phosphate pathway for a while now. I'm here just to intervene. I need to help you. I'm here to take you on a journey through the pentose phosphate pathway. Come on. In order to understand the pentose phosphate pathway, we'll be going through the following objectives, which are: what are the primary functions, where does it occur, and what are the reactions and substrates involved?
Boy, I should know all these things by now. I went through this biochemistry pathway over and over again, and this thing I want to stick in my head. I don't know what to do again now. Jason Matthews has been such a great teacher, and right about now I just drawing blanks. I don't know why.
Don't worry, Billy. As good as Jason Matthews is, things just don't stick. Now, there are three primary functions of the pentose phosphate pathway. Firstly, to supply body cells with NADPH. Can anyone tell me why NADPH is important?
NADPH serves as a biochemical reductant, providing reducing power for biosynthesis and detoxification reactions.
That is correct. And secondly, it is used for the production of ribose 6-phosphate. Yes?
This ribose 6-phosphate is an essential component for the synthesis of ATP, RNA, DNA, and cofactors such as CoA, NADPH, and FAD.
Yes. Finally, it produces the intermediates fructose 6-phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which allows the pathway to reconnect with glycolysis. It is also important to know where the pentose phosphate pathway takes place. This is in the cytosol.
The cytosol, I don't remember what is the cytosol, like my memory now started to juggle. I remember I learned this in the pathway. The cytosol is the translucent gel-like fluid that is found inside cell. Yes, right. And it's composed of protein and water. I now remember this thing.
It is also important to note that the pathway is most prominent in tissues where NADPH serves as a hydrogen and electron donor in reductive biosynthesis of fatty acids, cholesterol, neurotransmitters, and nucleotides.
It is also important in detoxification pathways for the reduction of oxidized glutathione and cytochrome P40 monoxygenase, since any DPH is needed by these. For us to understand the reactions involved, we can view the pentose phosphate pathway as occurring in two phases. The first is an oxidative phase where two irreversible oxidative reactions occur that produce two NADPH molecules. The starting substrate at this point is the glycolytic intermediate glucose-6-phosphate, which, as we know, obtained through the phosphorylation of glucose. In the first irreversible oxidative reaction, glucose-6-phosphate is oxidized to 6-phosphogluconolactone plus NADPH. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase, which also serves as a rate-limiting factor since it is inhibited by NADPH.
Oh, the higher levels of NADPH will affect the rate at which it is produced.
6-phosphogluconolactone then undergoes an hydrolysis reaction catalyzed by gluconolactonase, which gives phosphogluconate. 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase. 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase then catalyzes the oxidative decarboxylation of 6-phosphogluconate. Carbon 1 is lost as carbon dioxide to yield ribulose 5-phosphate. NAD+, serving as the electron acceptor, produces another NADPH molecule.
These reactions can be summarized as follows.
The second phase consists of a series of reversible non-oxidative interconversions whereby ribulose 5-phosphate is converted into ribose 5-phosphate or xylulose 5-phosphate in the reaction catalyzed by the enzyme phosphopentose isomerase.
By this stage, two of the three major functions of the pentose phosphate pathway have been established. That is the generation of NADPH and the production of ribose.
Yes, that's exactly it. All left to do now is to show how the pathway reconnects.
As mentioned earlier,
the pathway is most prominent in tissue cells involved in reductive biosynthesis. Since there is greater need for NADPH than ribose in such cells, extra ribose can be converted to glycolytic intermediates via three reactions, which involve the use of two enzymes, transketolase, which catalyzes the transfer of two carbons, and transaldolase, which catalyzes the transfer of three carbons, which is shown in these three reactions, where xylulose 5-phosphate plus ribose 5-phosphate gives you glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and cdioheptalose plus glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to give you erythrose and fructose 6-phosphate. Then erythrose plus xylulose 5-phosphate gives you glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and fructose 6-phosphate.
This pentose phosphate pathway thing doesn't only affect your academic life, but your social life as well. Real talk.
Real talk.
Yo, it's the biochemist in action here tonight. And we're just here to give you a little information about the pentose phosphate pathway. In case you didn't know, now you know. And you're tuned in with DJ Luke Dog, the sickest DJ out right now. Woke up this morning to the ring of my phone. I didn't know who was a caller, cause it was unknown. But say what? I answered it. At the same time, my classmate gave me some bad news to vibes with. You got a biochem exam today. OMG, what did you say? No, my mood just got downplayed. I jumped off my bed and put down the flyer skit. Even though I didn't know anything, I know I was going to write shit. Beep beep, it was my partner outside. Jumped in the car and went for a ride. Already forgot about that biochem exam. Damn, that lecturer is gonna diss my program. Then reach in school trying to be cool. Didn't know any biochem, felt like a fool. My clock was ticking, it was almost time to the hour. Everybody was excited but I was all out sour. Come inside, exam's about to start. When I heard that, it was like I got a bullet to the heart. Then I walked in slowly to the chair. Didn't know my reality was turning into a nightmare. Took out my pencil and my pen. It was like deja vu, it's all happening again. Now the paper was being shared. To me, this paper looked weird. It only had one question and it 27 marks. Lord forgive me for what I'm about to commit. Describe the relevant steps in the pentose phosphate pathway. Looking at this was like listening hip-hop in the form of reggae. Didn't have a clue what to write. Then my mind was hit with a bright light. I am your biochemistry godfather. This lecture reading like Ollie, he couldn't bring this paper any more harder. So I asked, what is the pathway? The biochemistry godfather replied, listen what I have to say. NADPH is produced by this pathway. The tissue needing this is responsible for making fatty acids and steroids, okay? So I asked, what about tissues that are less active in fatty acid synthesis? He replied, they're lacking the pentose phosphate pathway. At that point, I was feeling like a biochemistry mentalist. So as I began to start the first step, surely after this exam they're gonna nominate me for class rep. Then the biochemistry godfather said the first step is glucose 6 phosphate oxidized to ribulose 5 phosphate and carbon dioxide. When this happens, NAD plus is reduced and reduced to NADPH. So you sure that is true? The biochemistry godfather said, who talking, me or you? So I asked him what was the enzyme involved. He said three enzymes: glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, glucolactonase, 6-phosphoglutonate dehydrogenase. Writing this low mechanism was like running a race, with sweat dripping from my face and stopping like I disappeared without a trace. So he said, the second step is where ribulose 5-phosphate is converted to pentose 5-phosphate, including ribose 3-phosphate, which is used to make nucleic acid. No longer my mind felt blank or flaccid. I then jumped to the third step, and this was xylose 5-phosphate combined with ribose 5-phosphate to form cetyl-heptulose 7-phosphate and glycerol aldehyde 3-phosphate via the enzyme transketolase. Then I asked, is the mechanism done as yet? He replied, it's wetting after wetting, so don't you fret, you got two more steps to go. This biochem thing go make man go crazy straight to death row. So the next step is where cetyl-heptulose 7-phosphate and react with glycerol aldehyde 3-phosphate, and the product was fructose 6-phosphate and erythrose 4-phosphate, and the enzyme was transaldolase. The last step is where the enzyme transketolase transforms xylose 5-phosphate and erythrose 4-phosphate to fructose 6-phosphate plus glycerol aldehyde 3-phosphate. And now, the reaction is done. All I do is win, I lie, but I just won. Next time, make sure you learn your work before you choke off the biochemistry gun smoke.
Therefore, the higher levels of energy pH will affect the rate at which it is produced.
Good. In reactions catalyzed by phosphopentose something. I don't mix up there anyway.
So before I leave, I just wanna let you all know, you know, the best of luck in exams and whatnot, and you know, make sure and prepare in all aspects of the course online, because a lot of work has been done throughout the semester, and remember that there are podcasts online that will help you all out in every way possible, and
there are three primary functions of the pentose phosphate pathway. One is to supply the body with NAD pH.
Can anyone?
Yeah.
So who can tell me where does the pentose phosphate pathway go?
Me. The cytosol?
The curve. Oh, you dumbass. It's just as important as that.
What am I supposed to say?
Yes,
Actually,
you make a mistake with that part.
Yes. Ready, boy? Oh god, I'm recording already. That's more thing. You ready?
When you're ready, you start the recording.
So to fully understand the pentose phosphate pathway, we will be going through the following objectives, which are: what are the primary functions, where does it occur, and what are the reactions and substrates involved?
You know I should already.
Nah, start to worry.
Let's continue talking.
No, you see.